YouGuys.com presents Paradise, Louisiana. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Relief Windows, Visit Baton Rouge, an authentic Louisiana experience, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. Him coming from Superior Bait and Tackle on Seagull Lane. Look, we back with the mask. I don't know if I'm going to wear it the whole time, but right now we got people in the store. So I want to keep everybody safe. I want to be safe. This pandemic, and we're getting some people getting the vaccine, but it's still a very tough deal going on right now. So be careful. And let me tell y'all, stay tuned. We got a lot of fishing reports, and we got a lot of other stuff going on right now. The duck season has been going down. The only people killing ducks are in Oklahoma. So we'll bring that to you. We're going to visit Chess again. He's where all the fish are being caught in the Pontchartrain Basin. So stay tuned. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Seagull Lane over here, Superior Bait and Tackle.
My name's James Loop, and I won the 2020 Chevy 1500.
It was first day at roughly 5:30, 6 o'clock in the evening. I was like, let's stay fishing. And she's like, maybe we need to get back to the launch, you know? Yeah, I had a blast. It was a great summer tournament. Thank you, Super Chevy dealers, for my 2020 Silverado.
The best part about being a member of a Touchstone Energy Cooperative is that it's your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. That's the power of your co-op membership. Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
I've been asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did. So I finally just went to Benny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Benny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
For generations, anglers from across the globe have put their trust in Abu Garcia. Because out here on the water, we know our science is your religion. Fish like a fanatic with the latest generation of Revo. Featuring up to 24 pounds of max drag. Designed for leverage and power. Built on corrosion resistance and comfort. World-class adventure awaits with Revo. Abu Garcia for life.
Doing today is it's the winter time, it's cold, but we got a real sunny day. We're working some shoreline, some flats here, Them trout love to get up on them shallow flats to warm up on the warm, like the sunny winter days. It's a pretty one there. A little green trout that time. That's what's changed in this lake over the years is we used to not catch bass hanging out with speckled trout in Lake Pontchartrain itself, but it's a changing process. Ecosystem's changing. It's getting a lot more fresh out here. But it's just another species to be able to catch and have some fun with. And now they're mixed in with some speckled trout. There, shout out to the camera. So we were catching trout on the shoreline. We see these birds working, and it's perfect size red, wearing out the shrimp. They got little shrimp jumping everywhere, and I can see these reds, and they are busting these shrimps behind. Let's see if we can get in on these. Get a limit of these reds real quick. There he is. All right, here you go. I'm reeling this one in. Got my nephew Landon with me today. I hook him so fast. I let him reel him in. And I get another one out there. Thought it was gonna be trout at first, but I started seeing the reds bowling the surface. It's pretty radical. Pretty radical. On the screen. Double them up. Oh, I missed mine. Ah. Look at him eating the shrimp. Holy cow. Just now where I just pitched. There was a red eating a shrimp right next to the trolling motor. Totally awesome. Look at him, there's two of them. There's two of them right here. I don't even know the boat's here. There he is, look at that. Fish right on him. Holy mackerel. Holy mackerel. That is a serious school. Put that one in the pole holder. With the other camera, just how wild this is. There's one right there. Look at that fish right there. Eat shrimp. I'm gonna pitch right there and see if I can get him. That's a big one there, Papa. Got him. Got him. Oh. You can let that one go. He's huge. Show that one to the camera now. There he is. I mean, this is the sea of redfish right here.
There's a shrimp
hole. There's a shrimp layer. That's like a leech. That's not a shrimp. That's not... This is crazy, guys. Put it in my duct tape pole holder there. Look at this. That might be the coolest.
How you want a video? Let you go.
He's. Yeah, you ready? We're gonna go ahead and let this one go, guys. There he goes. You got this one to rail in and the one in the back of the boat. I'm going to tie on the top water. Landon's railing these in left and right. I'm going to throw on the top water. We got to get a top water explosion here. This is what we call pandemonium. All right, I'm going to help Landon out right here. He's going to be worn out if I just let him reel every single redfish in. These reds are pretty big, too. Completely awesome. Usually whenever we're fishing these reds under the birds, you gotta kinda work for them. It be a small flock of birds, diving in a very centralized location, and you gotta be right up on it. But this flock is incredible. It's about the size of 2 football fields. Everywhere I look, I'm seeing reds come out the water and hitting these about 70 count shrimp. It's mind blowing. Mind blowing. Oh, after all that, I lose mine at the boat. Can you believe that? Unbelievable. It's all right, because there's about 7 million more right here. Let me get the net.
I didn't even notice these are blue tails.
Yeah, they got blue tails. Sitting in, I hadn't really seen the birds dive for a minute, so I just started jigging the matrix. Look at this beauty here, baby. That's what I'm talking about. That's the thing, you find them white shrimp this time of year, especially with birds diving, you're gonna find big trout and big reds. That's a hog. Got him on the green hornet. I mean, this is awesome. Incredible. Go from big, beautiful slot reds to some bull reds to these big hammer trout. I mean, this is incredible. Let's see, let me get back out there. I'm just simply, the birds have kind of, they're just sitting. I'm just jigging it now. Oh, I missed him. Missed him, missed him, missed him. There's just shrimp in this area. Oh, missed him again. These fish are really nice, I tell you that. There he is. There he is. It's absolute studs, guys. Absolute studs. Look at them on the floor. Here we go.
For sidekicks, for those who see the glass half empty, for those who see it half full, for those on the right, for those on the left, for those with nicknames, for those with curves, for people that cycle, for people that recycle, for BFFs, for frenemies, for those with style, for lovers, for families, for big families, for everyone.
Pod's moving in storage.
I need to clean out my study.
We'll deliver a container.
My brother-in-law's moving in.
Maybe he'll help you pack.
He's lazy.
We can refer some professionals.
It's just until he finds work.
We can keep things at our storage center for as long as it takes.
I am not happy about this.
Or you can keep your things on site for quick unloading.
Did you say freeloading?
I said unloading.
I heard freeloading.
I'm sure you did.
Store on site or let us drive your things to our secure storage center. Pods, moving and storage solved.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, and this is going to be our combination hunting report. We'll come back later with a little short fishing report. But right now, the news is ducks. Where are the ducks? They're back doing the same thing they did years before. The best reports are beginning to come from Oklahoma. Duke Landry made a trip over there. He killed mallards. My grandson, who made a trip over there last week, they went for mallards. But they had a great hunt. They have a lot of widgeon. They killed gray ducks. They killed pintail. They brought home a lot of ducks. It was worth the trip. They didn't get the mallards they went to. They're going back this weekend and then the last week. This is the last weekend coming up for a lot of people, especially on the coastal zone. I talked to Ryan Lambert. Ryan was doing great every time, but the last week or so, not doing much. They do good one day, a fair one day, and then the next day there's no water. There's no water, there's no ducks. He said they're all offshore rafting. And there ain't nothing to bring them back in. If there ain't no water, they ain't got no water to come to. They ain't coming back in. That historically, that's it. He's talking about when the wildlife and fisheries come out next year and when they start setting seasons again. When they talk about the coastal zone, they need to do a study and say, hey, set the coastal zone only about when the tide is in and when the tide is out. And it might add a few days. So thanks for Ryan doing that. When Ryan's not killing ducks, they're not killing ducks. So that's what I'm trying to tell you. Now, the other places, they is mixed. Bobby Black up there in Tensaw in the Monroe area, they kill him one day and not the next. In the woods where I hunted with him for years, and the only reason I ain't been up there because it's been mixed. He don't want me to come all the way up there and then have a bad hunt. A lot of people I've talked to, they got leases in the Southwest, are calling their people, their good guests, and say, hey, don't come. There ain't no ducks flying. There ain't in the area. There's a lot of geese in the area from Arkansas all the way. My brother and them in Arkansas, geese everywhere. They're covered up, especially with speckled bellies. Same thing in Myrtle Rouge. I talked to Cody, and he didn't send me a picture like he was supposed to, but his youngest boy killed his first deer. He said, but the geese are everywhere. You can make a hunt. But like you said, with two or limited, it depends on what you want. Same thing in when I talk about Catahoula, I didn't get to talk to Blake. He must be busy or he must be up in his Canada leaf, wherever he's at. I didn't get to talk to him. He's always good about calling me back, but I didn't hear from him. But Brendan Dubrock and them, they still killing divers. In Catahoula area, they're killing divers, they're killing canvasbacks and other ducks. The only thing, that's not a big limit. But if it's on your bucket list to kill a canvasback, now's the time to go. The rest of it, as far as duck, and I can't tell you. I'll find out more when my son-in-law and my grandson go to Oklahoma this weekend. I'll know a little bit more about where to travel. So Arkansas, it ain't there where my brother got land. I haven't talked to the people in Port Barry. I got mixed hunts. Some blinds kill. They'll scratch out a limit. And my brother and them in the middle of the field, they might kill four or five. So that's it. That's far as the duck hunt. If you got a good report, this last week, Gary@ParadiseLouisiana.com. Going back to the deer hunt, I've been hearing a lot of reports killing deer. Bobby Black, all his guests in Tensaw killing beautiful, beautiful racks. If you look on the internet, the sportsmen, people are killing some beautiful deer and killing some beautiful bucks. I know we was right in the middle of the rut. We had some high water, and that high affects the ducks along the Chaffly in the Mississippi. But last week I mentioned the Kayes, a good friend of mine. The Kaye and his wife, Maria, they made a hunt and killed a doe late in the evening. And Maria helped him do it. When we come back, we're going to have the Berkeley. Abu Garcia Fishing Report. Superior Bait and Tackle on Seagull Lane.
Okay, Brett, safety and car insurance.
Never scored a safety. That's defense. But go on, please.
Yeah, defensive. That's exactly how you should drive.
There is no such thing as a defensive drive. Offense makes the drive.
Oh, I mean when you're on the road.
But it doesn't matter, home or away.
Okay, clearly I'm striking out here.
That's baseball.
Get great auto rates from Farm Bureau Insurance. Call your agent today.
Berkeley Powerbait Max Set. Elkfish's original Powerbait by 45%. Disperses a supercharged scent field that attracts more fish and triggers more strikes. Powerbait Max Set. Fish bite and won't let go.
Asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did, so I finally just went to Benny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Benny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
Welcome back to Superior Bait and Tackle and the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report. The name of the game, let me tell you this right now, is the marsh. In the Biloxi Marsh, in there in the Intercoastal, over there at Lake Catherine, Lake Bourne. They're going out there. Bass is the number one thing they're catching. They catch them on the best bait is live shrimp under a cork. I mean, anytime you can find a canal running into the Intercoastal, and you see where they got grass and water clearing up. Don't have to be real clear, but when the water's clearing up, just fish the outside of that grass. And with that cork, redfish, bass, unbelievable. They have to call to be over their limit. At Island Marina, they're coming in every day. Same thing at the Wrigley's. I saw a picture yesterday. Boy, come show me a picture. He was so proud. Table covered with bass. I asked him to send it, he didn't do it. Everybody's trying to stay away with this pandemic, but that's a good place to be safe. So if you got any questions, call those marinas, especially Island Marina, all their captains over there, Clint, DeArmas, and Mike, the fishing fool, just call them. I'm telling you, they got openings too. They got a few openings during the week or whenever. And if it ain't good, it's going to be windy. They'll find a place out of the wind to catch those bass. Now, I heard there's been reports for speckled trout. They're catching speckled trout in the rocks and everything in that area. Fouchon is mixed. I hear they're catching fish there. People are catching these fishing storm minnows, the live cockahoes, and they're catching fish all over, redfish and a few specks when they can get out on the rocks on the outside. Offshore, I heard a report from Venice Marina that they're catching tuna and wahoo. So I don't even know what season is open because I ain't been able to check right now. All I've been doing is trying to find out where sackle are and where the bass. Right now, Toledo Bend is number one spot. Everybody I know going to Toledo Bend, the weather's right, using shiners, they're catching some beautiful. I'm talking up to 2 pound sackle, white perch. Same thing up in North Lato and Saline. Their area, they're spider rigging, they had a lot of fresh water. But they've been working out and catching a few what they call specks or white perch, so in that area. Biloxi Marsh, I was telling you, there's another place that they're catching mixed bags. You can hunt, and the captains are finding some speckled trout in the bays in them, but if you just want to make sure you bring fish in, you want to catch redfish. Clint and them said they catch 3 and 4 limits of redfish every time they go. And then they hunt a few specks, and then the bass. The bass is just unbelievable. I've been having a few health problems, but I ain't been able to go, but I'm going to go as soon as I can. Still waiting on salters and them. With the holidays and them, he had some things he had to do, but him and Glenn and all those guys in the Sacale, they catching fish. Pizzle a lot of them are catching big in the Lake Verrett area. So down in Bob Black, Sacale are making a run. Beautiful Sacale. Black and chartreuse are still the color of the jig. So I'm going to leave something out, but most of the reports I'm telling you, head east, head south, go to Venice. Fish are biting everywhere, especially speckled trout and redfish. Stay tuned, we'll be back. When you watch Chaz, you can see some more shows of Chaz on the internet, on his websites, on our Matrix Chaz TV, any of them. All you got to do, Dockside TV. Check Chaz out. He gives the most informative young man right now in the water that there can be. Watching Paradise, Louisiana, please make a stop at your local dealer, especially right here at Superior Bait and Tackle. Now, see, I ain't going to be able to take my mask off. It's half full right now. On a Tuesday. See you later next week. Say your prayers. Stay safe. Stay strong. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
BBQGuys.com presents Paradise, Louisiana. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.